Hi, this is Oscar Gori, and I'm here to talk in this video about what real and effective user identities are in Linux and how to determine them. I'm going to use my CentOS 7 system called Server 1 for the demonstration portion of this video. Before we proceed, please note that the concept of real and effective user identities is universal and it applies to other major Linux distributions and versions as well. For more information on Linux, including exam preparation details for the Red Hat Certified Systems Administrator, Red Hat Certified Engineer, and CompTIA Linux Plus, powered by Linux Professional Institute, see my latest publications, RHCSA and RHCE, Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 3rd Edition, and CompTIA Linux Plus LPIC 1 1st Edition, available on major online retailers and app stores. Here is a list of the subtopics that we are going to discuss: the real user identity, the effective user identity, and the difference between the two. As we know that when an authorized user wants to log on to a Linux system, either at the console or in a terminal window, they need to submit their username with a valid password. The system performs a few checks and allows the user in if the entered credentials are validated. The user can run a command called logname, all one word, anytime throughout their login session to determine which user account they originally logged in as. Let us open a terminal session on server 1 and log on to it as a user called user 1, which I have already created on server 1. So we enter user 1 and then this user's password. And there you go. We are in as user 1. And we can confirm our identity with the logname command. And this identity is also reflected in the default command prompt, as you can see here. During our login session, we may need to switch our identity and become a different user to perform certain tasks as that user. For instance, we may want to become the root user to run administrative functions on the system. And as you know, we use the substitute user command called su for this purpose. So we type su at the command prompt and enter the root user's password. And here you go. We have switched our ID from user 1 to the root user. We can verify this switching by issuing a command called who am I, all one word. There are other commands available as well. However, I'll stick with this command for this presentation. The who am I command shows that we are root. Let's now run the logname command and see what it reports after this switching. There you go. The logname command still says that we are user 1. So why is there this discrepancy in the outputs of the two commands? Well, for those of you who are not aware of the difference between the logname and the who am I commands, the logname command always reports the user identity of the user who originally logged into the system when the terminal session was opened. In our case here, it is the user 1, and the who am I command reports the current user identity or the current effective user identity of the user who is running this command. Neither the logname nor the who am I command has any options available to modify their behavior, so they are pretty easy to use. Now that you have gained an understanding of the real and effective user identities, learned the difference between them, and viewed the use of the relevant commands, try these commands on your Linux system to solidify your understanding. And this concludes the overview of real and effective user IDs in Linux and how to determine them using simple commands. Thanks for watching this video.